Amen, amen, amen. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Amen. Oh God, let's exalt the name forever. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Amen. Let us exalt his name forever. Amen. I believe David said in Psalm 23 that he's preparing a table before us. Amen. So I'm just going to say, let's eat. Come on, somebody. Who's ready to eat this morning? Amen. Eat from the word. Amen. I believe there is a mighty word from God this morning. Amen. 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 Let's just look to God in prayer. Wait a minute. Before we do that, how many of us are just happy to be in the place? Amen. Those of you that are watching us online, how many of you just happy to be able to open up your eyes this morning? Happy to have breath in your body. So come on, somebody. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt the name of God forever, because he's worthy of our praise. Oh, come on, somebody. I don't know who I'm talking to. I don't know who may be watching online, but somebody needs to magnify the Lord this morning, because he's worthy of our praise. All right, let's pray. God, we thank you. God, we honor you and we adore you. And God, right now, we're here to just offer up this service to you this morning, oh God. Oh God, we pray that as we offer up songs of worship, God, and songs of praise, God, that it's a sweet sounding unto your ear today, oh God. Oh God, we're praying for a fresh rhema word this morning, oh God. God, strengthen Pastor Chris this morning where he needs it right now. Holy Spirit, endow him right now in the name of Jesus, because someone needs to hear a word from you today. And God, as we lift up these songs of praise, God, and as we lift up this word from on high, God, we pray that you accept our worship, oh God, and accept our praise, because you are worthy. You are the honored guest, the good, good Father, the good shepherd, the door, the gatekeeper. I am that I am. And we're here to just give you praise today, oh God. And God, we just pray, thank you right now. Thank you, oh God. We offer up this service to you. In your son Jesus' name, amen, amen. Oh, 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 oh
to lock eyes with somebody and think about all the things you've been blessed with just today. Just wake it up, right? All right? And I want you to tell them there's no God like Jehovah. Y'all ready? Lock eyes. Here we go. There's no God like
Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah.
There's no God like Jehovah.
There's no God like Jehovah.
Oh, yeah. Just this morning. Simple things like blinking. get up out of bed, right? I charge you with just trying to name them because you can't do it. You're so blessed and so abundantly blessed. He has so many more blessings to give. You can't name them all. He's awesome. We're going to share that today. From the rain, my God is awesome. He hears.
Oh, come on, give your awesome God an awesome praise. Come on, give your God. I said, don't give me a praise. Don't give Gail a praise. Don't give the musicians a praise. But if you serve an awesome God, and you've got breath in your body, give him an awesome praise right now. Whatever you do it, however you do it, oh, just tell them thank you. Amen, amen. You may be seated in the presence of our God. We praise God for this day and the opportunity to worship him again in spirit and in truth. There's so many things I want to talk about, but today my good friends Travis and Jackie Green are consecrating their church, Ford City Church, who we will be partnering with in many ministries, are consecrating their new edifice today at 10 o'clock. My helicopter should be here in a few minutes. But if I get a ticket, Judge, I'm coming to see you. But I'm going to take my time. But after I take my time, I've got to rush over there. Amen. It's nothing like having friends. Amen. And especially when God has done great things, all right, in the life history, you want to be there to support your friends. Also, talk with Don Staley this morning. Still, even though I don't travel with the women's team, still have spiritual oversight with them and pray for her team and our team as they look forward to winning her second national championship. Amen. 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 I'm going to close my eyes, but y'all put on your masks. I'm closing my eyes. Put on your mask. It is a requirement. I love you, but you got to have on a mask up in here. And y'all close your eyes too. Now, if I am not here next Sunday, it means my Tar Heels are in the Final Four, amen? So y'all pray for my Tar Heels as we go play for the Final Four tonight. As of course, Dawn Staley, that's a given. The girls are going to the Final Four and going to win another national championship. And I also want to, especially if you are an African-American female, I want you to praise God for Dawn Staley. She's our contemporary Rosa Parks. She's our contemporary Sojourner Truth. She's our contemporary Harriet Tubman, leading other African-American women to fight, to still fight. It's still a fight, amen? Still a fight for equality and equity. And she's the first female, especially African-American coach that I know making $3 million a year. I am sure that when she came here, she probably was making about $500,000 a year. Just wasn't paying female coaches the way they pay male coaches. And Dawn wasn't having that, amen? And always fight for your value. I don't care if you're male, female, black or white. Always, always fight for your value, amen? And we praise God for that. I'm also so very, very happy, and I'm going to get to what I'm going to talk about. As many of you know, I worked for Frank Martin for 10 years. He is my brother. He is my brother. His family is our family. And it was very tough over this last year as he was let go. But now, as God has closed one door, he's opened another door. Amen. And he will be announced as the new coach of the University of Massachusetts on tomorrow. What is also, I think, interesting, his wife is a graduate and was a track, zone track scholarship at the University of Massachusetts. So she's returning to her homeschool, and I know it's tough when you have to relocate your family and all that, but we're so happy that God closed one door, but he opened up a new door. But I'm also happy that your pastor is the new coach's first hire. Amen. I'm still going to be on staff at USC, and I praise God for that as well. So that means I'm still going to be away. I love y'all. But hey, listen here, now with technology, I heard y'all were, I was away one Sunday and y'all were shouting at the screen, amen? And I know that some people can't get with it, but hey, get with it. Hey, get with it. I might be in Alabama, Mississippi, Louisiana, but I might be on that screen, amen? But I want to thank God that that you all love me, and I love you even more. Let's see what God would have us to learn this morning. Turn with me to Matthew 25. I feel like preaching. Let's go to Matthew 25. We've been dealing with these talents. And I want to continue this story. And thank God for Reverend Damian Brown. I think he candidating like the... I need to let Damian know my job at USC is part-time, not full-time. And this don't get it twisted, Ashley. He's preaching up here like he thinks it's vacant. Might not be invited no more. Ashley, my therapist. We might have to talk, Ashley, because I was about to have to cut somebody. Hold me, Lord. But Matthew 25. 26. The King James Version says, his Lord answered and said unto him, thou wicked and slothful servant, thou knewest that I reap where I sow not, and gather where I have not strawed. Thou oughtest therefore to have put my money to the exchangers, and then at my coming I should have received my own with usury. Take therefore the talent from him, and give it unto him which hath 10 talents. For unto everyone that hath shall be given, and he shall have abundance. But from that, him that hath not shall be taken away, even that which he hath. Leave it right there, Damon or Tim. For unto everyone that hath shall be given. All right, let's break it down. To everybody I've given something to, they shall have a lot. But for those that I have given and have not done anything with it, it shall be taken away, even though they had it. That's the Chris Levy translation. I don't give everybody something, but if you don't use it, I'm taking it away. And my subject this morning comes from Job. The Lord giveth, and the Lord taketh away. The Lord giveth, and the Lord will taketh away. My brothers and my sisters, you've heard about this 1% of Americans. The wealthiest 1% of Americans control 32% of all wealth in the United States of America. Listen to this again. 1% of all Americans control 32% of the country's entire wealth. 9% of this country's population control 38% of this country's wealth. Combined together, 10% of the nation, and there are 330 million Americans, control 70% of the country's wealth. 1% almost controls a half of all money that circulates in the United States of America. They control 41.52 trillion dollars. 1%, that top 1% you've heard about, control $41 trillion. where 30% of the country, that's us, only has $2.6 trillion. This top 1% that you hear about, if you read the news or watch the news, they control wealth, control access to wealth in America. And anytime we speak of them, most times we speak of them negatively, and we speak of them in unfair terms. We think of them because they control so much money. And you do ask the question, what do you do with the $177 billion? I know somebody just said, I'll find a way. Just give me a chance and let me try. But they control the majority of money in this country, where we've got people still homeless and foodless and roofless. And I'm not talking about ruthless, without a roof. Now, again, some of them who are in the top 100 or in this 1% have generational wealth. The Hiltons, the Barons of the Ford family, the Barons of the Steels, Mills, and all of them. Some of them do have generational wealth. But it would be shocking to some to know that the richest Americans right now, and I'm going to tell you the top three, don't come from famous wealthy families in America. Now, you've heard of the Hiltons, all right? You've heard of the Vanderbilts. You've heard of the Fords. But the top three richest Americans today are first-generation billionaires. Number one is y'all's favorite, my favorite. Just one thumb to order any and everything I want and need from Amazon. You know his name, Jeff Bezos, the owner of Amazon, who started off with just an idea to sell books online with a little online reader called a Kindle. Anybody still? I still got it. It don't work, but I still got it. I'm gonna sell it at an auction one day. But he realized that there was a movement and a shift from what we call big store box stores like Sears and JCPenney's to this online industry and online commerce. And he realized that if people would buy books online, and if I could download and digitally get a book online, I don't know about y'all, but I come from a generation where we had lockers, and our biology book was like the Britannica. Come on, somebody. Come on, where my right school people at? We ain't old school. Where my right school? You know, we had lockers, and we had to go to our locker in between every class and switch out our algebra book for our biology book, and then switch out our biology book for our geography book, and then switch out our geography book for our literature book. Anybody, can you have a flashback one moment? And all my kids got is a computer. Y'all ready to go? Yep. And this was us. Can I get a witness? Y'all ready to go? Yep. At the bus stop at 4 a.m. Jeff Bezos says, you can get everything with a thumb. And that one idea has made him worth $177 billion. That's after he had to give his wife half. It's cheaper to keep her. $177 billion. And that's after a divorce. He had an idea and a vision. Number two is Elon Musk, the founder of Tesla. And everybody and their mama with these gas prices right now wish they had an electrical car. Elon Musk right now is worth $151 billion because he had a vision that instead of using gas and fossil fuels, that we should now use electricity to power our cars, that we should not have to be controlled really by Saudi Arabia and controlled by USSR, that we shouldn't have to be controlled by other countries to get fossil fuels to fuel our cars, that there can be battery power. that we can use, that you can plug up your car and plug up your pickup truck and plug up everything to power sources that even God can use through turbines and through dams and through windmills that can fuel everything that we need instead of having to be dependent on other countries that are at war with each other over oil. Yeah, yeah. Come on, dig deep, Pastor. And then Bill Gates, the founder of Microsoft. All right, and I'm sure if you work in any type of industry, somewhere, someone, you got to use a computer, even if it's an Apple, Microsoft on there somewhere. And he's worth $141 billion. The top three richest Americans in our nation are not men who got their money through generational wealth. They're not men who started off with rich families. They had an idea and a dream. God gave them a talent. They cultivated that talent, and their money multiplied. As I read this, Reverend Smith, I couldn't help but to think about Joseph. Couldn't help to think about Joseph's visions and his dreams. Joseph, you remember in chapter 37 of the book of Genesis, has two dreams. And unfortunately, he shares his dreams with his two brothers. I'm sorry to tell you, but many of you are old enough and seasoned enough to know right now you can't share everything God tells you with everybody. There are a few that you can share with, but you just can't share everything God has told you with everybody. There are haters on every corner. There are devils and potholes on every street. So you can't share everything with everybody. And he makes the mistake, Gail, of sharing his vision and his dreams with his brothers. And the problem is that the two visions and the two dreams that he got represent the relationship between him and them. He says that I had a dream that I was a sheaf, that I was really a flower. And even though I'm the baby of the bunch, my flower, my sheaf was bigger than y'all's. They're already mad at him because he's the baby boy. And I don't know if there are any babies in here, the baby child. We got problems already. But then our older brothers and sisters think we're always favored by our mamas, which we should be. It ain't my fault I came last. This is my position. And God put me in position to be the baby. And I'm 47 years old and going to remain the baby. Come on, babies, where you at? Come on, babies, where you at? And it's end up always we the one that got to take care of our parents when they get old. That's why our name should be first in the wheel and we should be beneficial. Let me stop. So the baby boy is loved by his daddy because he came late in life based upon a promise from God. He's not loved just because he's the baby boy. He's not loved just because he came from a wife that his father loved more than the other wives. He is the promised child. And anytime God has given you a promise and that promise manifests itself, you've got to love that. You've got to cultivate it. And he's really giving God the glory. But unfortunately, he gives it to Joseph in material things. One thing I struggle with, and thank God for my therapist, that material things don't make up for your time. They don't make up for your time. I know I'm preaching to myself. I know you're going to go ahead and text her what I just said. So he gives him a cloak of many colors. And then so the older brothers already don't like him. They're already jealous of him. And I'm sorry that you come from a large family where there's jealousy in your family. It really can tear a family apart. And you be the peacemaker, all right? You be the peacemaker. Don't be the one at the funeral trying to already get stuff from your mama's house before she even get in the ground, all right? You just can't imagine how people act after someone die. I think some of y'all know how they get fooled, all right? They get fooled, and so he's already jealous. They're already jealous of him, and so he says, "I had a dream that I'm taller than all y'all." Even though I'm the baby boy. And worse than that, He says that when I grew tall, y'all sheaves had to bow down to mine. He then has another dream that he saw himself as the sun and moon and 11 stars, and he being the 12th star, and his star was brighter than the other 11s. Not only will I be taller than you all, but my life will shine brighter than you all's. After that, you know the story, the brothers decide to kill him. But their older brother, I think Reuben, says, no, we can't kill him, he's still our brother. And how am I going to explain this to our daddy? So instead of killing him, what we're going to do is we're going to sell him away to slavery. We're going to act like he died. We're going to tell dad that some animals devoured him, and we're going to take that coat that represents his dad's favoritism, and we're going to soak it in blood and tell him that a wild animal killed him, but we're really going to sell him off to some Midianite traders. And you know the stories. You've been to Vacation Bible School. They take him down to Egypt, and I ain't got enough telling to tell you about all what happens in Egypt, but you know the story that he rises to the vice president of Egypt. First he was the secretary of agriculture. And then he becomes the vice president of Egypt. His star shines just like his vision told him. And then you know what else happens. There's a famine in the land. And when he's secretary of agriculture, he tells the guy in charge of Egypt, he tells the Pharaoh, he says, listen here, man, I got another vision, got another dream. He says, we're going to have 7 years of plenty, and then we're going to have 7 years of famine. He says, what we need to do is, even though we got a lot of money right now, we ain't going to Las Vegas. We ain't going to buy no new shoes. We ain't going to buy no new car. We ain't going to buy no new house. We're not going to buy another outfit because we can't even fit it in our closet right now. What we need to do is make sure we save it. And all of us need to have a rainy day fund. All right. I mean, listen here, y'all. We do not need to be living check to check. Because some of y'all, even in here with your nice Prada and your nice Gucci's and your nice stuff on and your nice car out in the yard, some of y'all might be one paycheck away from foreclosure because we don't save enough. And all of us need to be saving. Because you don't know when your rainy day gonna come. You don't know when your job moving to Mexico. That's why you need to have your own. Because I believe God has given us, I've been preaching all this these months about that God gives all of us a talent. He gives all of us something to use for his glory. And then when you use it for his glory, he'll do the rest. He allow you to live in abundance. And those of us who own our own business, there's nothing like locking your own door. Can I get a witness for someone who might, or even if you have an e-commerce business, nothing like closing down your app and see how much money done digitally come into your bank account. When you own your own stuff, and even if you don't own it, do the best that you can with what you got so that you can retire and don't have to worry about your Social Security check, that you have invested your money, that you saved your money, because there will come a time, hey, where there will be famine in everyone's life. And he said, let's save it. And it was true. There became a famine in the world. And everybody had to come to Egypt to buy corn from Joseph, including his 11 brothers. Just like his dream said, they had to bow down to him and buy corn from them. And you know something? My brothers and my sisters, he didn't fault them. He didn't say, they didn't recognize him. He recognized them. That's another sermon. You know, you need to be able to recognize your enemies before they even show up. All right, you should feel that lying, dirty coworker before they even hit you. You should feel a spirit walking around the cubicle before they even get there. That supervisor who be clocking you in, talking about why you took an hour and 1 minute for lunch, who be gone 3 hours. They had to come bow down to him. But here's the kicker, y'all. They didn't have to come to him, and he does not get his power until he's sold out. He doesn't get his power until his enemies try to kill him. See, sometimes you've got to understand that your prosperity will sometimes come from probation and profanity. Your prosperity will sometimes come from what seems to be probation, where you are caught, when you are controlled by others, where your livelihood is controlled by someone else. Because if you didn't have any family members who were on probation, you might as well be in jail. I mean, because I've been with some of our people and getting to the probation officer and all the stuff they got to go through, they might as well be in jail. And if you get a really mean probation officer who won't let you go nowhere, won't even let you use the restroom unless you call them. And then some of them make money off of them. That make you pay them $50 every time you come to the office to sign your paperwork. I'm glad y'all don't know nobody. At least y'all acting like. Maybe you don't. Let me stop. You would have never left that job if you hadn't been cussed out. You might have never left that relationship unless you had been cussed out. Sometimes God will lead us into our destiny by the demons and the devils in our lives. You know, you got to sometimes thank God for the Judases in your life. Because without Judas, Jesus does not get caught. Without Jesus being caught, he doesn't get to Calvary. Without him getting to Calvary, he doesn't die for my sins and your sins. Without him dying for my sins and your sins, he doesn't rise with all power on Sunday morning. Every now and then, I know we get upset with people who are jealous and who are the Judases in our life, but without Judas, you cannot get to your destiny. So right now, you need to thank God for all of your haters, because all of my haters have been my elevators. All my haters have been my excavators. All of my haters have been my elevators. And sometimes your haters that will get you to where God needs you to be, because they have been my excavators. What they have done really is clear the land to make my pathway straight. I just want to give somebody right now an opportunity to thank God for people who lied on you, people who tried to block your blessings, because whatever the devil meant for evil, God has meant it for good. We're going to have a praise party right now. I wish I could call them their names, but all my enemies live right here in Columbia, so they might be watching right now, but I just want to say thank you. But the more they talk about me, the higher I rise. Because you know what make a hot air balloon go up? Hot air. So every time they talk about you, they just giving you hot air. Every time they call your name, they just giving you hot air. And just like Michelle Obama said, we will rise. When they go low, we go high. And I wish somebody would praise God right now for everybody that tried to block your blessing. Because what they meant for evil, God meant it for your good. Can I get 5 more witnesses in here like T-Mobile that know that God will put your enemy under your feet, and then you make sure they stay alive to see you be blessed. Hey! Hey! Yes! Tell them thank you. Tell them thank you. You walk by that evil supervisor's door and say thank you. You walk by your ex-husband's house, don't go in the house, but just walk by, just pass by and say, thank you. That gold digger that's trying to take all your money, and now she's taking somebody other man's money, tell her, thank you for taking her away. Matter of fact, let me send you a gift card. You need to tell them thank you. For you led me to God's destiny. You had me stuck in probation, but because you tried to kill me, you tried to destroy me, God led me to my destiny. And because God gave me a talent, you can't take it away from me. And I'm going to use my talents so that God gets the glory. Set on down. You take a tour to the museum of your memories. If you walk down the pathways of your pain, you'll have some God notes. If you take again a museum, tour the museum of your memories, take a walk down the pathways of your pain, you'll see some God notes through your life. When I was working on my doctorate, One of my college professors, well, one of my PhD professors told me I needed to go to seminary. He said, because you just say stuff and you don't quote your source. I know you're not making it up. I know you're not plagiarizing. But in history, every time we get information and every time we take a passage from somewhere else, we got to put it in quotation marks and put a footnote on it and give whoever it came from credit from where it came from. I know you're not plagiarizing. I know the stuff is real and I know what you're talking about is true, but you write with authority, but you've got to give the person credit from where that authority comes from. And you write each one of your papers like you're preaching to me. You're in the wrong place. You really need to go to seminary. And this man had to sign off my master's thesis. This man had to sign off on me to go into the PhD program. I ain't gonna call his name. God bless him. But he wasn't blocking my blessings. And I told that man, wherever you don't see a footnote, just put in a God note. And I need some people right now to have a flashback of some times where you've seen some things happen in your life. And you don't know how grandma was able to make it without a husband, without a job, but she still sent all y'all to college. Don't know how your mama and daddy even made it when they separated and had all them heads of children to feed. You don't even know how you made it having to work in the library. See, some of the people had to work in the library and work in the cafeteria to pay their way through school. I wish I had some real folk in here. You don't understand what it means to be unemployed and have to live off an unemployment check. And you don't know how it means when somebody walks out on you, especially if it was your husband and the breadwinner of your home, and you done had to figure out life on your own and raise children by yourself in a one single mother home, and you don't know how you made it, but you made it somehow. Ain't no footnote for that. Anybody know there's only some God knows where God stepped in right on time? And I wish I had a witness here that could praise God for me. I don't know who did it. I don't know how they did it. Only thing I know is that God did it, and I want to give God the praise right now that he gave me some talent. And because what he's given to me, I don't want him to take it away. Yes, Lord. I want to thank the Lord, and I'm going to thank him right now on your behalf, because maybe you don't get excited as I get excited about it. But every time I think about the goodness of Jesus and all that is done for me, my soul shouts hallelujah. I just got to thank God for not only saving me, but not only delivering me, but not only helping me, but not only preparing me, but not only saving me, but I want to thank the Lord for every bountiful blessing that he's done for me. And right now I'm going to praise the Lord on your behalf. I'm going to give God praise for what he's done in your life. Won't he do it? I say, won't he do it? Anybody seen the miraculous works of Jesus? And that if you use all the talent that God has given unto you, he'll give you more. He'll give you more. Anybody living the abundant life right now? Anybody even doing better right now during this pandemic than you ever done ever in your life? You ought to give God the praise right now. And maybe some of y'all need to give God some praise on credit. You might not have it right now, but you know it's on the way. Come on, Holy Ghost. Come on, Holy Ghost. Come on, Holy Ghost. Send the flame of love about. God will. God will. God will. God will. Ah, yes. Woo! Thank you.
get quiet, man. Did not pastor just preach the walls down? I don't understand how we can sit when God, some of us are praising God on credit, amen? We thank God for what he's doing and what he's going to do. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Come on, how many of you know if it had not been for the Lord? Come on, as we stand all over the building. But we know that there's someone that may be watching us online or someone in this building that doesn't have a relationship with you. And if that's you and you want to right the ship, if you want to have a relationship with God, now is the time. If you don't have a relationship with God, now is the time. The Bible says that it's easy. Paul writes in Romans, he says that all you have to do is confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that Jesus, the Son of God, he died on the cross and he rose on the third day. And the Bible says that then you're saved. That's it. That's the relationship. That's all we have to do is confess it and believe it by faith that we are saved. And I'm believing by faith right now that someone has committed their life to Christ in this moment. So by faith, can we just go ahead and praise God for the lives that the enemy just lost? Okay, come on, somebody. Let's praise God for the lives that the enemy just lost. If you don't have a church home and you'd like to partner with Brookland, you can visit us online and put your information in. One of the deacons will reach out to you. Or just let us know on your way out that you want to just partner with Brooklyn. And we'll make sure we point you in the right direction. As well, if you need prayer, any prayer requests, you can just call the number that's on the screen. And one of our deacons will pray with you and just intercede on your behalf, amen? How many of us know that we need prayer? Everybody needs prayer sometimes, all the time, amen? Amen, amen. But I have to be obedient to the Spirit, amen, with every head bowed, because there's someone in this place and someone watching online that you have been praising God on credit and you haven't been using the talents that God has given you. But right now, God, we just come before you, God. We're praying that you activate the faith of those that have been sitting on their talents, God. We pray right now in the name of Jesus, oh God. God, we pray that you just move them, God, in the direction that you'd have them go, God. I pray for somebody right now under the sound of my voice, God, that has been struggling, God, with situations in their lives, God. The chains are just holding them down right now, God. I pray in the name of Jesus, God, that you break the yoke, God, that you break the chains, God, that are keeping them bound. God, we speak release in their lives right now in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, we thank you for the man servant, God. We pray traveling mercies for him right now in the name of Jesus, God. We thank you for your word from on high today, oh, God. And God, for those of you that, for those of them that, that want a relationship with you, God, we pray for them right now in the name of Jesus. And God, we say thank you. We won't sit on our talents. God, we just say thank you in your son Jesus' name. Amen, amen. You may be seated. I do have a couple of announcements real quick. But wasn't that a mighty word from on high today? Amen, amen. I thank God for our pastor and all his moving and shaking, and he still comes in and give God 120%. I thank God for him, amen. How many of you thank God for our pastor? Amen, amen. But there are some announcements that claim our attention. One being that we are hiring, amen. The church is hiring two positions, amen. We're looking for a community food promotion worker. Amen. I don't know if you guys remember a couple weeks ago, Pastor Chris was talking about we're going to have a greenhouse, amen. And we're going to provide fruit and vegetables and things of that nature to the community and those people that need it. And with that being said, we need someone to work that position, amen. So if you'd like to apply for that, please go online. Wish I can't see a Miss Frenchie. Okay. Just go online, right, and they can apply for that position, for those positions, for the greenhouse. And as well, we have a program coordinator for the food promotion program as well. So we have a community food promotion worker and a program coordinator food promotion for the food promotion programs. Two positions, that they're part-time positions, amen, that the church is hiring for those positions so that we can continue to be a blessing to the community, amen. And also, if you could, Tim, if we can put that slide up, today we'll be having a 5K run, amen, in honor of one of our own, Miss Justice Stewart. Justice was taken from us early in life by a drunk driver while she was running in North Carolina, in Fayetteville, North Carolina, and her mother, Tia, who's one of our youth advisors, she's put together a 5K run in honor of Justice today. And there'll be another one later in North Carolina, but today we're running for Justice. And it's gonna be at Richland Northeast, and the ceremony will start at 1:30, and the run will begin at 2 p.m. And she also told me to let you guys know that it's not too late to register if you'd like to register. So 1:30, the ceremony will start, and the run will begin at 2 p.m. And there'll also be a kids fun run from ages 2 to 10 that starts at 3, where they can come out and enjoy free in all caps, amen, pizza and snow cones. So today we just want to run in memory of Justice, whose life was taken very early by a drunk driver, amen. So that will be at Richland Northeast High School today at 1:30, and the run will start at 2, amen. All right, now it's offering time, amen. Amen. There we go. We give unto the Lord, and it shall be given back unto us. Amen. Amen. We have several ways you can give. Can we play some happy music, CJ? Just some happy giving music. Amen. We have several ways you can give. You can give online. Amen. And you can text the give. You can text the amount and text it to B&E Tithes and Offerings and the amount in front of that. And also you can give on the Shelby app. If you have the app, and if you're old school, as Pastor Chris would say, or right school, you can still bring it in on your way out. You can just place it in the offering buckets. Amen. How many of us just happy to give unto the Lord because he know that he will give it back to us? Amen. Amen. Well, let's stand all over the building. Amen. I'm just happy to be happy today. Amen. Amen. Let's look to God in prayer. God, we thank you, we honor you, and we adore you. We thank you for your son, Jesus. God, we thank you for the word from on high today, oh Lord. And God, we pray that as we leave this place, but never your presence, God, we pray that you continue to keep us and sustain us until we meet again. Oh God, we just say thank you. And we give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. In your matchless son, Jesus' name, we pray. Amen, amen. You all have a blessed week, amen.